ears, and sounds. Sounds come from vibrations. Vibration creates sounds, waves which move through medium such as air and water before reaching our ears. Sounds can't travel through a vacuum. A vacuum is an area empty of matter. Our ear vibrates in similar ways to the original source of the vibration, allowing us to hear many different sounds. When traveling through water, sounds travel 4 times faster than when it travels through air. Sounds used by many animals to detect danger, warning them of possible attacks before they even happen. Dogs can hear sounds at a higher frequency than humans, allowing them to hear noises that we can't hear. Our ears help us detect sounds. Ears convert sound waves into nerves and impulses that are sent to the brain. While your ear picks up the sounds, it's your brain that does all the hard work of making it sense of it all. This is the pinna. The pinna collects the vibration. The vibrations goes through the ear canal. From the ear canal, it goes to the eardrum. The eardrum shakes and then the vibrations goes to the three bones: the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup. Then the vibrations goes to the cochlea. The cochlea has something called fluid. It's not a liquid. Then the vibration goes to the nerve and then goes to the brain, and the brain explains the sounds. Thank you for watching.
Good morning. Today I'm going to tell about the ear. The ear is the organ of hearing and balance. The ear has 3 parts: the outer ear, the middle ear, and the inner ear. The outer ear. The outer ear consists of the pinna and ear canal. The outer ear. Here's the ear canal and here's the pinna. The middle ear. The middle ear consists of the tympanic cavity and the ossicles. The middle ear. Here's the ossicles have the 3 parts: mallets, incus, stapes. The tympanic membrane. Tympanic cavity. The eardrum can also be known as the tympanic membrane. It separates the outer ear from the middle ear. Its function is to transmit sounds from the ear to the ossicles in the middle ear, then to the cochlea. The cochlea sends signals to the brain and allows the organism to hear. The inner ear. The inner ear consists of the semicircular ducts which enable balance and eye tracking when moving. The atrial and ossicle which enable balance when stationary, and the cochlea which enable hearing. Here's the atrial and ossicle. And here's the semicircular duct, and here's the cochlea. Here's the semicircular duct and the cochlea. The cochlea and semicircular duct are connected with each other. And here's the tympanic cavity, and here's the tympanic membrane. And thank you for listening.
I'm going to talk about Planet X. The size of Planet X is 10 times bigger than Earth. Planet X orbits about 20 times further from the Sun than Neptune. Planet X may take between 10,000 and 20,000 Earth years to make one full orbit around the Sun. Planet X has not been discovered yet. The predictions is based on mathematical modeling. Thank you for watching.
the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea, also known as the Salt Sea, is a salt lake bordering Jordan to the east and Palestine to the west. This is the map of the Dead Sea. On the shores of the Dead Sea is white, crystal, and dry all year round. This is the white crystals on the Dead Sea. Dead Sea isn't actually a sea at all. It's really a lake. It's the lowest point on Earth. This is the shores of the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea is 67 kilometers long and 18 kilometers wide. The Dead Sea believed to be 3 million years old. This is the salt on the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea, one of the world's saltest bodies of water, that makes it a harsh environment in which animals cannot live. Dead Sea black mud is one worldwide known for improving skin's natural processes. Dead Sea was Cleopatra's one of the most favorite places. This is the mud of the Dead Sea. Thank you for listening.
The Super Volcano. The Super Volcano is a large volcano that has had an eruption of magnitude 8. It is the largest eruption on the Volcanic Explosivity Index, VEI. A supervolcano eruption can be a single short-term event or a large outpouring of lava lasting up to millions of years. Supervolcanoes occur when the magma in the mantle rises into the crust and unable to break through. So pressure builds in a large and growing magma pool until the crust is unable to contain the pressure. This can happen at hot spots, for example, the Yellowstone caldera, or at subduction zones, for example, tuba, or as large igneous cavities which can cover huge areas with lava and volcanic ash, causing long-lasting climate change that can threaten species to extinction. Okay. The Reunio eruption in New Zealand's Taupo volcano is the world's most recent super eruption as magnitude 8 eruption. This is a picture of a large igneous provinces. Volcanic ash. It blew up in this volcanic ash. This is a large igneous provinces with lava. It blew up in lava. And this is the Yellowstone caldera volcano. And this is volcanic lightning. This happens when there is fraction between the ash. Volcanic ash. So lightning forms. And this is a picture of the radius. This is a picture of the volcanic ash radius. As you can see. Thank you.